everybody. I'm Farron Cousins, and this is The Daily Left, your interactive source for progressive news and commentary. Thanks for joining me. Today's top story, House Judiciary Committee Chairman John Conyers has once again subpoenaed Karl Rove to testify before the committee about his involvement in the firing of 9 U.S. attorneys, as well as his role in the prosecution of former Alabama Governor Don Siegelman. The subpoena calls for Rove to testify before the committee on February 2nd about the overall politicization of the Justice Department. This is the second time that Conyers has subpoenaed Rove, and it's uncertain as to whether Rove will be compelled to testify, as Obama's Attorney General has not yet been confirmed. In a statement issued early this morning, Rove's lawyer said that former presidents usually retain their claims of executive privilege, which he says will prevent Rove from testifying. Conyers' Judiciary Committee sued for information regarding the firing of the U.S. attorneys last year, and his case was passed to the District of Columbia's Court of Appeals after a federal judge refused President Bush's claim of absolute executive immunity. If Rove continues to refuse to show up, Congress does have the authority to send out the sergeant-at-arms to arrest Rove, a move that the House would have to approve. However, given the larger Democratic majorities in the House and a president who will fight for them, this plan might actually be carried out if Rove continues to defy the law.
Your move, creep.
And speaking of defying the law, the United Nations Special Rapporteur on Torture, Manfred Novak, told CNN that the U.S. has an obligation to investigate whether Bush administration officials ordered torture, adding that he believes that there is already enough evidence to prosecute former Secretary of Defense Donald Rumsfeld. Novak told CNN that they made it clear in their UN report that Rumsfeld had ordered the use of torture, but he said the issue is whether or not U.S. law will recognize the forms of torture that the administration admitted to using. A bipartisan Senate report released last month found Rumsfeld and other top administration officials responsible for abuse of Guantanamo detainees in U.S. custody. It said Rumsfeld authorized harsh interrogation techniques on December 2, 2002 at the Guantanamo prison, although he ruled them out a month later. In addition, both George Bush and Dick Cheney have admitted that they authorized methods that would be considered torture. In spite of all of this evidence, a recent survey found that only 25% of the American public believes that the administration is guilty of war crimes and should be prosecuted. And finally today, disgraced former Lehman Brothers CEO Richard Fuld has sold his $13 million home to his wife for a mere $100. According to real estate records that were recently uncovered, Fuld sold his home on November 10, 2008 in a quick claim filing, which is usually the case seen with couples who are divorcing. However, there are no reports of marital problems in the Fuld house, and most believe that the sale is to protect the home from the flurry of lawsuits that he's expecting. During his tenure at Lehman, Fuld received yearly bonuses of up to $22 million, made more than $74 million in the last 2 years as the firm was floundering, and was the target of a grand jury investigation into securities fraud. Authorities believe that the securities fraud contributed to the firm's collapse and caused a plethora of workers to lose pension and retirement funds. If anyone was ripe for a lawsuit, it was Fuld. We'll have to wait and see if his real estate shuffle will prevent him from losing everything he has stolen from the company. And that's all I've got for you today, but if you like our videos, I encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking on the subscribe button right above. I'm Farron Cousins, and thanks for watching Go Left TV, Citizens Media on the Rise.